Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. And today I'm doing this lunchtime video because I wanted to talk a little bit about restraining orders. Because I see so many, you know, people who get restraining orders against people, but the restraining order seems to work against them, okay? A restraining order, or it's also called an order of protection, is a form of a legal injunction that requires somebody to do something, or to refrain from doing something, or doing certain things against you, okay? And people who refuse to comply with the order, they face criminal or civil penalties and may have to pay damages or accept sanctions. And breaches of restraining orders can be considered serious criminal offenses that merit arrest and possible prison sentences. Now, what I've found, you know, over the years looking at women, particularly women, because I don't see too many men who get restraining orders, but, you know, I see women who get restraining orders, you know, against men, and the restraining order doesn't work for them because they think the restraining order is it. That just because you have a guy under a restraining order that he's going to obey the restraining order. That's not true. When you put somebody under restraining order, all that does is legally protect you in case you have to kill a motherfucker. Okay? And see, the thing about it is so many women, you know, first of all, they, you know, and this is the, and I can only speak from my experience and what I've seen, because I've only gotten a restraining order against somebody one time, and that was my husband, who was just acting a fool. And I didn't really know that he wouldn't do nothing, but you never know. So I got a restraining order against his ass. But, cause you know, let me tell you, I protect myself. Okay. But anyway, in case I have to do something to you, you know, I'm not going to the prison, the penitentiary. All right. Whatever I do is going to be within legal bounds. But anyway, I see women who, you know, they get in an argument with their boyfriend. And I've seen, now, sisters, you know, you've seen this too. I've seen women really push a man to hit them, okay? When the man hit them, now they want to get a restraining order. After they've aggravated them to a point. See, the thing is that at some point you learn not to aggravate a person to the point where you know that they'll lose it. You understand what I'm saying? I mean, at some point you have to learn how to, you know, contain yourself, because you can't beat a man. I don't give a damn what you do. You can't beat a man. And then the next thing you know, you got police and all this shit and courts and stuff in your business. So, you know, if the relationship is so tumultuous that you have to resort to calling the police, it's time for you to go. You know, and one thing I've learned, and I'm just going to put this on record, you don't make no announcement that you're leaving. Okay? Because you don't know how a person will take it. Because some people have nothing to lose. And I'm not saying this is just for women. I'm saying men too. I know women, you know, men have left women, and women that came and burnt up their clothes, tore up their cars, you know, broke their windows out on their cars, just do all kind of stuff because they leave them. And so, you know, when you get a restraining order from somebody on somebody, that just basically protects you to me. In the event that you have to protect yourself, you know? And not only that, it also, you know, serves as a way, like if they're not supposed to come around and you see them coming around, they are violating that restraining order, okay? And you're supposed to call them on the violation of that restraining order. Now, a lot of times people don't wanna do that, but like I said, why did you get it in the first place? You know what I'm saying? If you weren't fearful, you know, or you weren't trying to protect yourself, why would you get one in the first place if you're not going to use it? That's what restraining orders are for. See, one thing about the law, and I hear a lot of black people say the laws don't work for them, but yes, they do. You just have to know the damn law. That's all. A lot of black people will initiate the law, but they don't follow through. And that's why it doesn't work. But the laws of this land does work. You just have to follow through on your damn end, okay? Like, you know, they say, well, there's a lot of innocent people still locked up in jail. They innocent and locked up because something they didn't do right. Because if your ass innocent, you ain't supposed to be in jail. I mean, it's just simple. Like, I know it's probably a little bit more intricate for some people, and some people might say, well, you know, it's deeper than that and all that kind of shit like that. But I'm like, no, if you're innocent, then you should be able to prove your innocence. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, like I said, you have some people who they can be placed somewhere and can't nobody prove they were at this particular place or something like that, you know, and that's what gets you there, is that you either don't remember, you can't fill in detail, you get nervous talking to a district attorney or being questioned by somebody, you're intimidated, okay? But when you know you haven't done something, you should be able to articulate your innocence. And that's why language is important and knowing the law is important, okay? Because there are laws in this land that protect you. And if you don't know these laws, then you'll be subject to these laws, okay? You'll be subject to everybody who wants to violate these laws, you know, against you. So, you know, when you get a restraining order, don't think that the person that you're getting it against is going to honor it. You still have to protect yourself. You still have to look around. You still have to be observant. You still have to make sure that that restraining order is upheld. Because there are many women who got a restraining order. And they got a restraining order. And the dude still, you know, was around and, you know, and stuff like that. And they never enforce the restraining order. Didn't they tell you, didn't I say I didn't want you to come around me no more? But see, the thing is that they get these restraining orders and they really don't mean it. You see what I'm saying? Never get a restraining order from somebody unless you mean you don't want them around you no more. That ain't a temporary fix for your relationship. That's what I'm saying. So if you and your guy get into it, don't just call the police and then get a restraining order, then you back with them like 2 days later. You know, that's abusing the damn system. You know, which is why, you know, a lot of times enforcers of it don't take things really serious, is because it's been so misused. It's been misused as a band-aid or as a weapon used against someone to temporarily get them off of your ass. But a restraining order means you want this motherfucker not coming around you no damn more. Okay? Simple as that. And if you think that this motherfucker is that damn volatile, then a restraining order ain't gonna stop him. You understand? Mentioning a restraining order, telling him or her that you getting ready to leave, no, you don't do that. You know, when that motherfucker look up, you be gone. That's how that work, babies and all. You be to pack your shit and gone, and he don't know where your ass is at. Don't go to your mama house, don't go to any house you think he or she know you will be at. You know, because if you really do, and you know that this person is crazy enough to do something to you, then, hey, you got to protect yourself. That's all I'm saying. And a restraining order is not going to do it. That only gives you, to me, for me, it only gives me protection of myself in case this motherfucker run up on me and I got to plant something in his ass to get him up off me. And I'm in my right because he's violated his restraining order. You know what I'm saying? So when you see somebody, you see this person that has a restraining order and they're coming to your house, you call the police and say, hey, I got a restraining order against this motherfucker, and you know this nigga coming through that door, then you can plant something in that ass and be in your full right because you've done what you were supposed to do to restrain, have this person under an order by the courts, by the law, to stay away from you. So I just wanted to do this video about a restraining order and to let you know that, you know, just because you get one, that doesn't fully protect you, you know, from an individual. People don't honor shit, let alone a restraining order, if they want your ass. But I'm telling you to protect your ass from going to the penitentiary for having to kill somebody. Okay, so that's just a step in protection of yourself within the law. And like I said, the law works, you understand, but you have to know the law. And you know, I just came into this realization like maybe a couple of years ago, because I'm involved with a group of people, and that's what we talk about. We talk about, you know, law and things like that. And all you have to do, all we have to do is know the law. That's why, like I said, so many people sitting up in jail is because they don't know the law, you know, and their rights are violated because they don't know that they have the law on their sides, you know, particularly if they're not in the wrong. You know what I mean? Particularly if they're not in the wrong. And if they are in the wrong, they better have enough money to pay their way out of it. See, a lot of people do wrong and get out of it because they got money to pay out of it. But for a poor motherfucker, you ain't got no money to get out of it. You understand? So first of all, you gotta not do anything to get your ass in up under the auspices of the law. You understand? Where they coming down on you. You know, and if something happens and you involved in something, you be the innocent one. You make sure that you're not at fault. You understand? So, you know, I've been just thinking about the law and how the law can be something that you can use to your advantage. But like I said, sometimes people just don't have the wherewithal. They don't have the patience to follow things through. See, it takes a lot of follow through, paperwork, following up. You know, calling, bugging people, going down, talking to people. It takes a lot of, because it's thousands and thousands of people doing the same thing. But I've learned that the squeaky wheel gets the oil. So if you that squeaky wheel, guess what? You're going to get some oil. Okay, you can't sit on your ass and wait for somebody to go through the paperwork and pull your name out. Uh-uh. Your shit ain't that important to other people. Your shit is important to you. So you have to get up off your ass and make shit move. That's all I'm saying. So my suggestion to each and everyone is to utilize the law. It is available for you. The laws can work for you because they're not just, you know, laws in America. Some of those laws are been around for thousands of years. They're just framed in a sense for a society. But, you know, they've been around for a long time, and you just have to know how the laws work. You know, you have to, particularly if you're under some kind of, you have a case or something like that, you have to do case study yourself. Don't expect your attorney or your public defender to do case study for you. You have to study cases related to your case. You understand, where you can point out discrepancies or things in the law that can assist you to get, you know, some relief from whatever you're involved in. So my thing is to study the law. Study the language of the law, get you a Black Laws Dictionary, study you the language of the law, and if you have a case, study case studies that have to do with your case. You know what I'm saying? And that way you'll be prepared when you walk up in a court of law, because a lot of times we have a public defender because we can't afford a lawyer. But I'm telling you, if you got your homework together, you can help that public defender defend your case. Because the thing for me is, what I've noticed with public defenders, their goal is to get a conviction. You know, their goal is to move that with the judge and the prosecuting attorney. They just want to move that shit out, and that's why they always trying to get you to take a plea bargain. But if you ain't did shit, and you have to be able to study the law to know your rights, or else they will railroad you into a plea of guilty. You know, or and for the case of brothers that's like locked up, you know, and I feel so sorry for them because they have no one. Some of them don't have anyone on the outside who have the knowledge They don't have the thrust to feel your case and take it on as though it's theirs and do the work to bring the information to you so that you will be able to be more informed when you go in front of a judge. And, you know, I'd also like to say that I see sometimes people go in front of the judge, and I've seen people clapping people for doing this, but they go in front of the judge, they cuss out the judge and cuss out the court and all that kind of stuff. That don't get you nothing but more time, dummy. Not unless you just enjoy being in jail. You know what I'm saying? I mean, sometimes you have to understand that you have to have a different mindset when you step into a courtroom. You know, there's a whole different language inside of a courtroom. And I've been learning that lately, you know, that it's a whole different ball game when you get inside a courtroom. And all that emotionality and shit, it don't work in a courtroom. You know what I'm saying? You can hop up on top of the judge's desk and slap him around, but that ain't gonna do nothing but get you more time. That's all. And particularly if you're innocent. So you just have to learn how to have restraint, learn how to study. Hopefully you have somebody outside, if you can't make bail, to help you with your case, along with your court-appointed attorney. I suggest never represent yourself unless you know exactly what you're doing, not unless you know the language of the court, because you do have a right to represent yourself, but you got to know the language of the court, and you can't go in there talking about the damn Constitution, your constitutional rights. There are other things that you have to know outside of your constitutional rights that are related to your constitutional rights, but you got to be able to tie that shit in. That's what I'm learning, So you could go cite your constitutional rights in the Constitution all you want to. You can cite that all you want to. I'm just saying that you better have some other shit to back that Constitution up. That's all I'm saying. Don't just go in there talking about your violation of your constitutional rights. Another thing I learned about judges and jurisdictions of judges is that they have the right to put judges that aren't in certain jurisdictions in these jurisdictions and sit on a bench. I learned that. That's an Article 1 judge, or that's an Article 2. But they can take an Article 1 judge and put them in an Article 2 court. I think that's how the terminology, I can't think of it right now. But anyway, they have the right to do that. And so when the people who argue, well, that's an Article 4 judge, and he's sitting in an Article 1 court or some shit like that, they can do that. I read somewhere that they can do that. So, you got to know the law. You got to know the laws of your state. You have to know your city laws. You understand what I'm saying? If you got a city beef, or you got a state beef or a federal case or whatever, you got to know the laws that go along with that, okay, to save yourself. So, back to the restraining order. Don't think a restraining order will restrain somebody. It only helps you in case you have to kill a motherfucker. That's what it's for. Or you put somebody away for violation and you're safe. You can have them locked up. That's basically what's for. Most of the time when people want to enforce that law, it's because somebody is violating that restraining order, and sometimes it's not in the appropriate time where you can have them arrested, for doing something to you. You have to take that sucker out right there and say, hey, I had a restraining order. I called y'all to let you know he was here. It took you so long to get here. By the time, I had put the phone on the hook, he was coming through the door. She was coming through the door, or she was tearing up my car. You know what I'm saying? Or something to that nature. So, you got to know how to use the law, and I'm really learning how to use the law. You know what I'm saying? To my advantage. And so, with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist. Just know that the laws can't work for you. Okay? Even if you black, the laws can't work for you too. A lot of y'all just don't want to take the time and effort to work the law. And you put too much trust in your attorneys. And that's the same thing I feel about doctors. You don't put all your trust in an attorney or anybody outside of yourself. You got to know damn near as much as they do about what's wrong with you. Okay? You got to be able to articulate what's wrong with you. So if you're not astute as far as being able to relate things to people, and you're intimidated by people simply because they have a degree or they have some kind of stature or something like that, then you're going to be messed up. You don't let people's position intimidate you when this comes to you. You have to know everything about whatever is affecting you, okay? And that's how you win, all right? So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist. Peace, everybody.